Good morning, children. How are you? Okay. So we were doing the exercises in the book. I hope you have kept your books open. Ready to work? Our first exercise on page 28. On page number 28. What is there? Let's work in pair. You are one person and I am another. Now it says, what would you do if you were the head of this school? The answer given by the other person says, I would take all the students on a picnic. Everybody loves to go on a picnic. Same here, even I love it. Now, next question is, you don't have to worry. You just have to look into the book and listen to me. What would you do if you were the famous sports person? See, this is how we frame questions. What would you do if you were a famous sports person? And a question mark, because it's a question. Don't forget a question mark. How will you answer here? I would. Who do you see in the picture here? Is it Sanya Mirza? Okay. I would play for my country and bring glory to it. Means bring glory to it is bringing good name to your country. Okay. Next is, what would you do if you were a scientist? What do scientists do? I would make inventions and discoveries to help the mankind. I would make inventions and discoveries to help the mankind. Now, what would you do if you were a class teacher? What does a class teacher do? I would help my children, like you are there. I would help my children to become good citizens or good human beings. What is very important in life? To earn the money or to be very beautiful? No, not at all. Very important is to be a good human being. The most important is to be a good human being. What would you do if you were a pilot? Pilot is a profession. It's a kind of a job. So how should we do our jobs? Happily and honestly. So if I were a pilot, I would do my duty honestly. What would you do if you were a musician? What do musicians do? Singing and playing instruments. I would spread. To live in harmony. A feeling of living in harmony through my singing. I can aware people. I can make people aware about living in harmony. Is it good to fight with each other? No, not at all. Okay. Our next exercise is, let's listen. Page 29. Now here we have some words where it is OW at the end. like we have cow, we have town, we have how, we have brown, we have town, we have crown. Now just speak these words with me. Cow, town, how, brown, town, crown. So what's the voice coming for OW? Ow. What's the voice for OW? Ow. But on the next page, if you see, OW gives you the sound of O. It's only O. Like yellow. I know it. No. Window. Just think of other words where OW has a sound of arm and where OW has a sound of O. You can play with your brother or sister, Didi or your mom, using these sounds of OW, the different sounds of OW. Now, this was a fun game. Next exercise on page 29 is you learning the use of, this is important, learning the use of past continuous tense. Past continuous tense. This is something you need to understand. The exercise, I'll be giving you the answers to your exercise in the worksheet part. Okay, you can note down from there in your notebooks. You can note down from the worksheet in your notebooks. But let's understand here. Now, past tense is, remember there are three kinds of tenses: present tense, past tense, future tense. Past tense is when we talk of the time which has gone over. Time which has got over is past tense. But when I say past continuous, then it is the time when the work was happening. It is the point of time. It is the point of time. Like if I say, what's the time now? Around 10. Now, if I say, what were you doing at 10 yesterday? What were you doing at 10 o'clock yesterday? So what will you say? At 10 o'clock, I was studying. So the work was happening at 10 o'clock. Then there is a helping verb, that was, and verb is study. The verb is study. Let's understand how do we use it. I use verb plus ing. And the helping verb should be was or were. Was we use for singular and were we use for plural. Singular means one person and plural means many people. Now, what is it? How do I make a sentence? I say I am one, so I say I was. I was, I said verb plus ing. I was playing at 6 o'clock the evening. Clear? Because I am one, I said with singular using was verb with ing. Verb with ing. I was playing at 6 o'clock in the evening. Now same thing. You have 5 sentences there. No, you have five sentences there for which you have to make questions. This I am doing in the worksheet. Don't panic. Just understand. What were the children doing, or what were the children playing all evening? The children were playing cricket all evening. Your brother was writing letters when I saw him. For this, we have to make a question using what. What were brother is one or many? One brother, no? It's not brothers. So what was your brother doing when I saw him? Question is, so put a question mark. Now let's see, am I doing correct or not? There are two conditions, one here, another here. Have I used verb with ing? Yes. Have I used was for singular and verb for plural? Was. Yes. Now, if it was brothers, I would have said, what were your brothers doing? Clear? So, this is how we use past continuous. Can we have two more sentences? Don't look into the book now. Don't look into the book. Sometimes you ask your father, no? You make a phone call to your father and he is busy. So later on you ask him, Papa, what were you doing when I made a phone call to you? Now, Papa is one. So why did I say were? Because with you, we must use only were. With you, it is always were. Was is never used. It is a rule. We need to follow the rules. With you, we never use. Maybe you is used for one person. But we will not use was. We will use only were. I hope you like the exercise. You will practice some more with your parents, with your sisters and brothers at home, and continue speaking in English. Okay? We'll do more exercises in the next class. Worksheet I am sending you. Do this exercise in the notebook. In the notebook. Okay? Okay, the class gets over here.